One of the inputs that's really valuable to monitor with a turbocharged engine is the exhaust manifold backpressure, or EMAP as it's often referred to. What this does is gives us an idea of how well sized the turbocharger is for a particular application. And it is very application dependent. For example, in a drag application where boost response isn't so critical, we might be aiming to have the exhaust back pressure below boost pressure. On the other hand, for a street driven car where we want good response, we're much more likely to see our exhaust back pressure exceed the boost pressure by as much as 1.5 or even 2 times. The issue, of course, is if we want that data, how do we get it? Because the exhaust manifold is a pretty unfriendly place where it's very, very hot and it's subject to vibration, we can't mount the sensor directly to it. Instead, what we can do, though, is tap the exhaust manifold for our pressure sensor, remotely mount the pressure sensor, and then we can run some tubing between the exhaust manifold and the sensor. Typically, when we do this, we'll also add some coils into that section of tubing, and this just adds a little bit of additional length, which helps dissipate the heat of the exhaust gas before it reaches the sensor. Once we've got that data, we can then run this into our ECU or data logger and make use of the data with sizing our turbocharger. It's also not data that we strictly need on the car all the time. This is often something that we'd only use for dyno development before removing when the car is being run out on the racetrack.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.